A visiting American delegation concludes its trade mission in the Philippines. U.S. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo met Tuesday with the Filipino business community at the close of their two-day trip. The meeting included members of the elite Makati Business Club and of the American Chamber of Commerce. Raimondo hailed progress by the government to make the Philippines more business-friendly. She also reaffirmed Washington's commitment to Manila to further strengthening cooperation between the longtime allies.
President Marcos, it seems to me, is doing all the right things to make your country more business friendly, easier to do business in, and that's just music to our ears in the U.S. and to the delegation that I brought. The message is the United States is committed to the Philippines, is going to continue to show up in the Philippines. These business leaders that I've brought want to continue to show up and do more and more here. Why the Philippines? Because it's special, right? We are engaging more and more economically in the Indo-Pacific region, but the Philippines is special.
Philippine House lawmakers expressed their dismay over the no-show of South Korean firm Miru Systems, which was supposed to conduct a demonstration of its automated counting machines. Victoria Tula joins us on the line for the details. Victoria?
Ron, lawmakers were gravely disappointed when the joint venture of South Korean firm Miru Systems Company Limited did not show up in the hearing of the House Committee on Suffrage and Electoral Reforms to discuss the preparations for the 2025 midterm elections. The joint venture won the contract to provide the hardware, software, and election management system. Miru was scheduled to do a demonstration of its automated counting machine during the hearing this morning, but it was canceled. According to Mountain Province Representative Maximo Dalug Jr., chairman of the House Committee, COMELEC Chairman George Garcia wrote the committee to inform it that they need to customize the machine and take into account the comments of various stakeholders. According to the committee secretariat, since the demonstration was canceled, representatives of Miru opted to not come. Rizal Representative Emigdio Tanhuatco III asked the purpose of the hearing if they could not question Miru. He also said it is a bit disrespectful for Miru to not come since the hearing today was already rescheduled to accommodate requests. For Cagayan de Oro City Representative Rufus Rodriguez, the poll body should have done its due diligence in determining Miru's capability, considering that there are allegations and reports of problematic elections in the Democratic Republic of Congo and Iraq. According to COMELEC Commissioner Marlon Castejo, they have a certification from the Electoral Management Body of Congo and a statement from the United Nations Assistance Mission of Iraq about the execution of elections in the two countries. Rodriguez, however, said the poll body should have sought the side of groups that reported negatively on the elections to know if Miru is truly qualified. He said it is an act of negligence to not do so. ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro remarked that the background of Miru should have been thoroughly scrutinized before the contract was awarded. Tanhuatco requested to have a demonstration of Miru's machines before the notice to proceed is signed. Representatives of the three Filipino companies, which are partners of Miru, will also be made to attend. Casqueo said he will ask the commission and bank if they could do the next hearing and demonstration next week. Ron?
Victoria Tulad with that story. Thanks.
Haiti's Prime Minister Ariel Henry steps down after weeks of mounting pressure and increasing violence in his country. Henry says his government will leave office once a transitional council is established and his replacement is appointed. His resignation comes as armed gangs that have gained control over the Haitian capital Port-au-Prince called for his resignation. This prompted Henry to travel to Kenya in late February to secure its support for a United Nations-backed security mission. But the prime minister ended up stranded in Puerto Rico after the conflict dramatically escalated in his absence.